Hi everyone, it's Vershi again. Today we're back to another challenge day of IELTS speaking test. A sample test, of course. So it's the day 17th. If you're accidentally watching this right now, this is more a personal practice. If you would like to continue watching, here could be an example of band 6 answer. So alright, let's start it. Alright, today's topic, after getting to know about the information, personal information, we gonna have new questions about something else. For today is about art, which I'm not so familiar with. Did you enjoy doing art lessons when you were a child? In fact, I do. I took a class lesson, I think in grade 4, and I love the painting, but not quite the shading. I find it challenging when it comes to do find the right shade and the light of the drawing. So that part is difficult for me. Okay, moving on to next question. Do you ever draw or paint pictures now? To be honest, I love seeing painting, but when it comes to drawing by my own, I find it's kind of boring. I do not like it that much. I think the main reason is because I find it difficult to draw nice. So that's the main reason for it. Alright, let's move on to next question. When was the last time you went to an art gallery or exhibition? In fact, I visited a museum of art during a tourist trip to Paris. So, of course, the famous museum in Paris is Le Musée de Louvre, I think, if I pronounce the French correctly. So it's a very big museum, and we spent around only 3 hours because it's not in the schedule of the tourists, of the tourist guide. I believe that I should visit that place again in the near future, I hope. Okay, what kind of pictures do you like having in your home? As a matter of fact, I like modern art, something that similar, something that bright. Some people call it contemporary art. So the main reason I like this type of painting is because it makes the room brighter, look more spacious, and also give a touch of characteristics to the room. Alright, let's move on to part 2. So today we have a topic about describe a time when you visited a friend or family member at their workplace. You should say who you visited, where this person worked, why you visited this person's workplace, and explain how you felt about visiting this person's workplace. Okay, so I would have 1 minute to think about this. Alright, so while thinking about visiting a friend's or family member's workplace, there's a lot of examples of experience of memories that come up to my mind, but the one that stands out the most is the time we went to visit my brother's workplace. The reason why it's worth to mention to you is because it's the new experience for us. First of all, it's not in our hometown. It's in a foreign country, which has so much thing different from us, from the cultures, from the language that they speak. As a matter of fact, my brother graduated from a university in USA, and fortunately, he got accepted in a big corporation in the US. So, I think you might know it. It's a Google. So it's a well and big corporations that we using the search engine on the internet. So the famous thing about this place from the newspapers that we've been reading since many times ago about free foods and a lot of place for entertainments and relax. So the thing about that make it so excited to visit this place. And in fact, when we put our foot on his workplace, is a blast. It was a blast. There's so many food stores. The space is tremendously huge. There's so many things that we never seen before, because it's from another countries and it's from a very big corporations. We do not have that in our countries. In fact, the biggest country in the biggest company in Vietnam is nothing compared to that kind of corporations. So those things made of literally jaw-dropping, and what's more about that is that we felt we so proud of our brothers. I forgot to mention that we visit that place with my whole family, and we all so proud of our brothers. So we happy. So long story short, because of it's so something so new, so unfamiliar to all of us, and it's something that so big and so glamorous. So we felt so excited and also proud of the achievement that my brothers have made. So those are the things that that I should say north down from this place. Never mind, is end of 2 minutes. So let's move on part 2, 3. Different kinds of workplace. So it's about the expanding topic of part 2. What things make an office comfortable to work in? Well, it depends on people's perspectives. Different group of people have different perspectives. Outgoing person might love a workplace that have a lot of entertainment areas, like place for them to relax, to have some mini games like billiard, pool, something that people can come together, engaging in the games, building relationships. But others people, introvert for example, they might need places that more need more privacy, and those places might be like meditation areas, yoga classes in the workplace. So for them, that could be more comfortable to work in. All right, moving on. Why do some people prefer to work outdoors? So I think is something similar to the previous questions about the perspectives of different people. I think that is their priorities, their preference about how they would love to work. Some people liked the outdoors, and it gives them the freedom that they feel that they needed. They feel that the four wall could make them feel like a prison. They prefer to work remotely whenever, so they can work whenever they want. Or some people love to go out to meet people. They want to connect with directly face to face with different people, so they would prefer to work outdoors so that they can achieve that type of personal need, I think. All right. So next question. Do you agree that building people work? Do you agree that the building people work in is more important than the colleges they work with? I'm on the fence about this question. On the one hand, I believe that the building is really important, is have all the facilities they need for the comfortable. However, it depends on the work. If they need to work with a lot of their college, like face to face, like need to talk, to communicate with each other, then colleges play a big role in the comfortable level of the workplace. Because if you don't happy with, if you're not happy with your colleges, you might quit your job the next day. So it's not sustainable for that person. It's not sustainable for the business. So all parties loses in this game. So it depend is is really depends to the way the conditions. I think the requirement of the work itself. All right, let's move on to the next question, the importance of work. What could life be like if people didn't have to work? What would life be like if people didn't have to work? Interesting question. So is well, initially, it sounds like a good plan that we do not need to work. However, if we do not to work, there will be less of the stress, less of the competitions in the for people to move on forward, to develop further. So most of the evolution and revolution of the human histories come from work. So without work, I believe that we would stand still, or maybe fall back from the revolutions of the world of the time. All right, let's move on to next question. Are all jobs of equal importance? I would say not totally. Although I believe that we should treat all job equally. However, the importance of on your job is depends on the situations in different time. So, for example, in the time that we need some emergencies of the work, the most important of the job during that time would be the ambulance, the hospitals, the healthcare services. So in that situation, you don't need much of let's say a businessman, business salesman. So it's really depends on the situations that we are in. So that the level of importance of the job is flexible, depends on the situations. All right, last question. Why do some people become workaholics? In my mind, I think people become workaholic because they love their job. They want to achieve more in their job. It's something to do with their feelings. It's like a people who like to be, who stay competitive, and he or she want to move ahead in their job ladder. So he or she might become workaholics because he believes that the way to become success. However, there's people who became workaholics just because they need to make a living, and they need to make a lot of money for their loved one. For example, a lot of people might want to make a good life for their next generation. To be more specific, it's about their kids, their children. So they try to provide them with a good environment and good food on the table. So because of that, they might become workaholics. So I think those are might be a reasonable cause of workaholic people. So I think that's it for today. Thank you for watching, and really sorry about my daughter. She's kids, unpredictable. All right, bye-bye, see you tomorrow.